This is part 16 of Angular CLI tutorial. In this video, we'll discuss how to display linting errors in Visual Studio Code. So here's what we want to do. We want to display linting errors within Visual Studio Code editor in the form of red squiggly lines, as you can see right here. So we as developers have the opportunity to fix these errors as we are writing our application code. At the moment, our editor Visual Studio Code is not able to display linting errors. Let's actually prove this. Let's introduce a few linting errors. We know a comment must start with a space, so let's remove this space. This is one linting error. Missing semicolon is another linting error. Missing white space right here is another one. And let's use var keyword to declare a variable. Now this is another linting error because var keyword is forbidden. Now at the moment, notice Visual Studio Code is not able to display the linting errors that we have right here. Now let's run ng-lint command. There we go. We've got four linting errors within this file, app.component.ts, but our editor, Visual Studio Code, is not able to display any of them. Now for Visual Studio Code to be able to display linting errors, we have to install an extension, and that extension is tslint. Now let's look at the steps required to get this extension installed. The easiest way to install an extension in Visual Studio Code is by using the extensions window. At the moment, as you can see, the Explorer window is open. There are a few ways to get to the extensions window. Click on the view menu and then select extensions, or you can use the keyboard shortcut Ctrl+Shift+X, or you can click on this extensions icon right here. And then within the search text box, search for the extension that you want to install. In our case, we want to install this extension, tslint, and then click the install button to get this extension installed. There we go. Tslint extension is successfully installed. To activate it, we'll have to reload Visual Studio Code. And to do that, simply click this reload button, and on the prompt that you get, click reload window. Notice with tslint extension activated, we can see linting errors within Visual Studio Code itself. These red squiggly lines let us know about the linting rules that we have violated. In this case, we are missing a white space, and here we are using the forbidden keyword var to declare a variable. Here we are missing a semicolon, and here the comment must start with a space. Since Visual Studio Code is now able to display these linting errors, we have the opportunity to fix them as we are writing code. There are two approaches to fix these linting errors. One approach is to manually fix them. To manually fix these linting errors, simply hover the mouse over the red squiggly line. We'll then come to know about the linting rule that we have violated. In this case, it's asking us either to use let or const keywords to declare our variable instead of using the forbidden var keyword. So let's fix this manually. Let's use the let keyword here to declare our variable. The other approach to fix these linting errors is by asking Visual Studio Code to do that for us. To ask Visual Studio Code to fix these linting errors, simply click on the location where you have the linting error, and then a light bulb appears. Once I click on the light bulb, in this case we see three options. The first option is to fix the error itself, the second option is to disable the rule, and the third option is to see the documentation for that specific rule. So it's going to launch the browser, and then in this case it's showing us the documentation for semicolon rule. Now if we want this error to be fixed, select the first option, fix. Notice in this case it has automatically fixed that error for us. Let's fix this error as well. So when I click on the error, we have the light bulb. Let's select fix option, and let's see what we get with this error. When I click on the light bulb, in this case we only have one option, and that is to disable the rule. So this error does not support automatic fix, so we'll have to manually fix it. Let's save all these changes and then run ng-lint command once again. There we go. All files pass linting. At the moment, within our Angular project, we don't have any linting errors. Now, for some reason, if you want to disable the tslint extension that we have installed, then go to the installed tab. Again, this is within the extensions window, and then click on the settings icon against this tslint extension. And then here we have disable option. Select that option to disable the tslint extension. And for it to take effect, you'll have to reload Visual Studio Code by clicking the reload button. To enable it back, click on the settings icon again and then select enable. And then we'll have to reload Visual Studio Code again for the changes to take effect. So TSLint is definitely a great tool to have in our toolbox. Thank you for listening and have a great day.